Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Alhamdulillahirabbil alamin wassalatu wassalamu ala asyrofil anbiya wal mursalin sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajmain. Honorable speakers, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, to open our agenda of the day, the International Seminar on International Investment Law and Transfer of Technology and Workshop on Intellectual Property Rights, let us recite Basmalah together, that Allah may bestow His grace upon us and count our event today as ibadah. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Ladies and gentlemen, to begin our agenda of the day, let us listen to the recital of Holy Quran that will be delivered by Abi Kuhafa. To Abi Kuhafa, time is yours.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. A'udzu billahi minasy syaithanir rajim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Ya ayyuhalladzina amanu kunu qawwamina bil qist. Kunu qawwamina bil qisti syuhada walau ala anfusikum awil walidaini wal aqrabin. In yakun ghaniyan aw faqiran fallahu awla bihima. Fala tattabi'ul hawa وَإِن تَلْوُوا أَوْ تُعْرِضُوا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرًا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا آمنوا بالله ورسوله والكتاب الذي نزل على رسوله والكتاب الذي أنزل من قبل وَمَن يَكْفُرْ بِاللَّهِ وَمَلَائِكَتِهِ وَكُتُبِهِ وَرُسُلِهِ واليوم الآخر فقد ضل ضلالا بعيدا. صدق الله العظيم.
والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Thank you, Abi Kuhafa. Hopefully with the recital of holy verses from Quran Karim that we have just listened to will enlighten us for the rest of the day. Ladies and gentlemen, the next agenda will be singing the national anthem of Indonesia Raya that will be led by one of our students, Sakinah Azahara. To Sakinah Azahara, time and place is yours. Attendees, please stand.
Thank you.
Thank you, Sakinah Azahara. The following agenda will be welcoming speech by the Chief of Association of Indonesian Intellectual Property Rights Center, Dr. Budi Agus Riswandi, SHMH. To Dr. Budi Agus Riswandi, time is yours.
The Honorable Dr. Kamran, as the representative of PSIP project and IP expert from Switzerland, the Honorable Vice Dean of Faculty of Law, distinguished all of speaker and participant in this seminar, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
First of all, I would like to introduce to all about ASCII organization. ASCII organization was established November 2017, and the ASCII organization is an organization that conducting to develop IP knowledge and IP management for the member of ASCII organization and society in Indonesia. The member of ASCII organization come from personal and intellectual property right in university and research institution in Indonesia. Now, we have more than 120 members. Ladies and gentlemen, today the ASCII organization in collaboration with ESIP project and Faculty of Law Universitas Islam Indonesia are implementing international seminar and the workshop training. The international seminar is regarding the international investment law and transfer of technology. And also, the workshop training is regarding international patent filing system. Let's focus to the international seminar. It is very important for us. Why? Because there are some regulation and policy for investment and transfer of technology national and international. It will cause two impact. The first, positive impact, and the second, negative impact. From the negative impact, it will cause some problem, such as the investor will taking natural resources management. It will cause social, economic, and legal problem. So we need to discuss about international investment law and transfer of technology. Ladies and gentlemen, as the head of ASCII organization, I hope all of speaker and participant can sharing information about international investment law and transfer of technology. And also, all of speaker and all of participant can joining in international seminar until finish. Finally, enjoying your international seminar and thank you very much. Good morning. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you, Dr. Budi Agus Riswandi. The following will be opening speech from the representative of Swiss Federal Institute of Intellectual Property, Dr. Kamran Hausyangpour. To Dr. Kamran Haushangpour, time is yours.
Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you hear me. So, very happy to be here in Yogyakarta, first time for me, and very happy that to see so many people interested and motivated to talk about this topic, which is actually, in fact, a very important topic, the intellectual property. So, of course, not all the seminar will be about intellectual property, but at least a great part of it. This seminar is taking place in the frame of ISP, which was mentioned before. ISP is a project between Switzerland and Indonesia. Now, in the second phase, even in the first phase, we had several collaborations with the Indonesian IP office and also other IP-related institutions like Beckraff and so on in Indonesia. In the second part, in fact, the collaboration is mainly with ASCII, and we try to participate as good as we can to the, let's say, goals which was set by ASCII in order to raise awareness about IP and especially about, of course, technology transfer at the universities, which is a great deal and a lot of work, I know, but for everything should be a start, and I think that is a good start today. What we are going to do, at least in the second part, the second session, if you are interested and you are there, we are going to talk about more details about a very special aspect, which is PCT filing. But up until now, in fact, it's enough to say that. So welcome, and I hope you enjoy these 2 days. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Kamran Haushangpour. The next will be welcoming speech by the Dean of Faculty of Law, Universitas Islam Indonesia, who will be represented by Vice Dean for Religious, Student and Alumni Affairs, Dr. Andes Muntoha SH MAG. Time is yours.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Honorable speakers, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, it is our pleasure to warmly welcome you to Faculty of Law, Universitas Islam Indonesia, for this particular agenda of International Seminar on International Investment and Transfer of Technology, combined with workshop for international patent filing system held today and on the following day. At a first glance, our faculty might have seemed as such a small one, but the small campus is witness of the history of how the Indonesian people briefly and unwaveringly fought on our independence. Universitas Islam Indonesia was established by the very founding fathers who also built our nation during its early days as an independent country. The first vice president of the Republic of Indonesia, Muhammad Hatta, who then stood alongside Insinyur Soekarno proclaiming the country's independence, Muhammad Yamin, the first minister of law and human rights in the post-independence era, who named this faculty of law building, we name after Muhammad Rum, Wahid Hashim, Kahar Mudhakir, and many others. In short, Universitas Islam Indonesia is the first university in this country that built by the very hands of Indonesians as an independent nation, down its first stone, entirely free the colonial invention or as a result of nationalization, the already established Dutch institutions. Ladies and gentlemen, surviving the test of time and with its it is distinct belief of with a long tradition of freedom. Faculty of Law Universitas Islam Indonesia is persistently committed to honor its predecessor by continuously producing alumni that bring significant influence for Indonesia and beyond. It is all because we acknowledge that while the fight for independence has long cooled down, the fight to fill in the independence is still very much on its peaks. Among countless battle fields to which Indonesia has to send its proof, it is countries partakes in international economic and everything that correlates. In this case, international investment and intellectual property rights issues. Distinguished guests, when we talk about international investment, we are essentially talking about the swing of the pendulum between developed nations as the capital exporters and the developing ones as indeed the capital importers, whereby Indonesia is included as the latter. Indonesia has become so what a hub, the center of the packet international investment traffic in the Asia Pacific region, among many reasons why, one of which is the undebated fact that the country's soil in abundantly rich or nature resources available to be harnessed. Indonesia is also home to a great number of human capitals, which is still what is lacking in the money capital acute. Scientific knowledge and technologies, most are even patents. Therefore, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, this is precisely why we gather here today, to hear more and to have a series on in-depth discussion about international investment as well as the intellectual property issues that come along with it, which in this case, the transfer of technology and international patent filing system. I do hope through this fruitful event, we can receive many benefits for all the participants. I wish all yous are able to gain new understanding and expand our insight through this international seminar and workshop. At the end, my speech allow me to send my highest gratitude to the all speakers who have intended to become the honorable speaker and trainers in our agenda. Also, my appreciation is given for all committee and participant who take part and have made this event come to life. Thank you very much. Billahi taufiq wal hidayah. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you Bapak Dr. Dr. Andes Muntoha SHMAG. Ladies and gentlemen, before entering into the core agenda of the day, we would like to play you a short video on the profile of Universitas Islam Indonesia. Please enjoy.
Yogyakarta, siang dan malam menampilkan ribuan wajah unik, budaya, seni, dan insan dari berbagai belahan dunia berkumpul menjadi satu. Pendidikan merupakan salah satu wajah Yogyakarta yang tidak bisa diabaikan. Lebih dari 300 ribu mahasiswa yang telah menuntut ilmu di kota pendidikan ini. Dan tidak sedikit dari mereka telah membuktikan diri menjadi generasi yang unggul bagi bangsa. Berdiri sejak tahun 1945, Universitas Islam Indonesia kini telah berhasil menempati jajaran perguruan tinggi terbaik di Indonesia yang berlandaskan semangat nilai keislaman dan kebangsaan. Kami percaya bahwa pendidikan yang baik tidak hanya mengantar mahasiswa menuju masa depan yang cemerlang, namun juga membekali mereka dengan nilai keagamaan yang kuat, menjadikan generasi yang beramal ilmiah dan berilmu amalia. Komitmen untuk menjadi universitas dengan pilar penelitian yang kuat telah mengantarkan UII menerima kehormatan dalam pemeringkatan Kementerian Riset, Teknologi dan Pendidikan Tinggi Republik Indonesia sebagai perguruan tinggi swasta dengan kinerja penelitian terbaik di Indonesia pada tahun 2016. Dengan fasilitas berkelas dunia, UII telah terakreditasi institusi A dan mendapatkan penilaian overall ranking QS Star 3 bintang dari lembaga pemeringkatan Quakorelsim sebagai bentuk pengakuan internasional. Kerjasama aktif dengan lebih dari 123 institusi internasional yang tersebar di berbagai penjuru benua memberikan kesempatan bagi mahasiswa untuk memperluas wawasan, mobilitas, dan pengetahuan guna memenangkan persaingan global. Ilmu pengetahuan tidak selalu terbatas di dalam kelas, karena kita diciptakan untuk terus mengeksplorasi alam sekeliling kita. Bahkan hingga puncak tertinggi. Kami yakin inovasi berkelanjutan menciptakan kemajuan, dan kemajuan akan mendorong kita menjadi bangsa yang unggul dan kompetitif di era global ini. Inspirasi dapat datang di mana saja dan kapan saja. Dan dengan kampus terpadu seluas lebih dari 35 hektar yang menjuarai Green Awards di tahun 2016 pada kategori Green Campus, UII merupakan kampus ideal untuk mengasah ilmu dan mengembangkan diri. Sejak kita lahir, kita terus belajar. Belajar dari pengalaman dan belajar dari masa lalu. Kesempurnaan diri datang dari langkah kecil penuh percaya diri. Kami yakin di UII, langkah kecil bisa menjadi lompatan yang besar. Dengan lebih dari 83 ribu alumni yang tersebar di seluruh tanah air dan penjuru dunia, kami siap untuk membantumu bergabung bersama mereka. Masa depan ada di tanganmu, dan kami siap menunjukkan jalannya.
Honorable speakers, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, entering the core agenda of the day, the International Seminar on International Investment Law and Transfer of Technology, first session, which will be led by our moderator for today, Mrs. Ratna Hartanto, SHLLM. Ladies and gentlemen, Mrs. Ratna Hartanto, SHLLM, concluded her bachelor degree education in Gajah Mada University, Yogyakarta, as well as her internationally based law education for master degree in Gajah Mada University, Yogyakarta. She is now a lecturer in Universitas Islam Indonesia, teaching three subjects for the time being: commercial law, company law, and obligation law. Ladies and gentlemen, Mrs. Ratna Hartanto, SHLLM.
Please welcome in front Dr. Kamran, Mr. Nandang Sutrisno, and then Prof. Sefriani and Dr. Anissa. The Honorable Persons, the Vice Dean of Faculty of Law, Universitas Islam Indonesia, Dr. Dr. Andes Muntoha, MAG. The Honorable, the Head of Undergraduate Study Program, Dr. Budi Agus Riswandi. The Honorable, the Head of Doctoral Program, Professor Jawahir Tontowi, PhD. The Honorable, all of the lecturers and all of the participants of today's international seminars, good morning and assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thanks to Allah the Almighty that blessing us so we can join this international seminar today. Salawat and salam may be delivered to our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ladies and gentlemen, based on the data from the World Bank regarding Ease of Doing Business Index or EODB Index, Indonesia is ranked 106th in 2016, and then the index jumped higher into 91st position in 2017, and then becoming in position 72nd among 190 economies in 2018. However, this position is getting down in the end of 2018, and now Indonesia is ranked 73rd. Of the 11 indicators used by the World Bank in the EODB assessment, Indonesia showed improvement in three indicators. For indicators of ease of starting business, Indonesia has succeeded cutting and simplifying procedures for recording administrative taxes, social security, and licensing. For indicators of ease of property registration, Indonesia has succeeded in increasing administrative efficiency. For indicators of getting credit information, Indonesia has succeeded in developing better credit information system. But however, other indicators that do not show improvement are the ease in licensing construction, the ease of getting electricity, and the strengthening of the rights of creditors and debtors. In addition, Indonesia has not shown improvement in protecting minority investors, ease in paying taxes, trading between countries, or